treating macular degeneration with a patient's own cells. Stem cell therapy for eye disease gets closer to the clinic. Kapil Bharti, PhD, Statman investigator at the National Eye Institute, discusses age-related macular degeneration. Animations showing the eye and stem cell therapy appear throughout the video, along with visuals of patients, doctors, and researchers in medical settings.
AMD, age-related macular degeneration, has a late stage called the dry AMD. Patients go blind because the retina cells and the photoreceptor cells, which perceive light and convert it into electrical signals, die off. So the way I see it is, it's like a camera. The light passes through the lens, through the front of the eye, hits the back of the eye, the retina, and the cells in the retina called the photoreceptors that collect the light, converts it into electrical signals, sent through the retina and the optic nerve to the brain so we can see. RPE, retinal pigment epithelium, is a layer of cells that in a healthy eye and nourishes and supports the photoreceptors. But in AMD patients, RPE cells degenerate and die off, and as a result, photoreceptors lose their nourishment and they die off and patients go blind. The types of people affected by AMD are mostly older people. It starts manifesting over the age of 60, 65, and then as age progresses, it keeps getting worse. Above the age of 80, it's thought that 1 in 4, 1 in 5 people are affected by it. Symptoms of AMD start off as spotty vision in the central part of your vision and sometimes blurry and wavy vision. But as the disease progresses, people really lose a big chunk of their central vision and go blind in the central part of their vision. The procedure that we have developed in this new clinical trial is actually aimed to replace patients' degenerated tissue. We have been able to make healthy RPE cells from patients on stem cells, which when engrafted into the back of the eye, will replace that degenerate layer. Once it integrates with patient's surrounding tissue, it will start supporting the photoreceptors. It may halt and reverse progression of disease, and as a result, it's going to restore patient's vision. So this new treatment is different from a previous treatment in many different ways. One is that in the previous treatments, people have just injected cells. And these cells don't work very well if they're just injected. And second, people have used embryonic stem cells. We are using patients on stem cells, so they are more autologous to their patients on body cells, so they won't be immune rejected by a patient's body. Third, our cells are on a biodegradable scaffold, so they will have a much higher chance of integrating in the back of the eye. Creating one RPE patch for a given patient takes almost 6 months. We start with patient blood, reprogram that into iPS cells or induced pluripotent stem cells, and these cells can make any cell type of the body. So we take these cells and make RPE cells out of it, and take those RPE cells, we grow an RPE patch from these cells on a scaffold. We had to optimize the fiber thickness, the hole diameter, and everything so the cells would form a monolayer on top of our scaffold. To transfer this RPE patch under the patient retina, we pick up the patch in one orientation and bring it to the back of the eye, guide the patch under the retina as the retina is made ready for transplantation. The scaffold that we're using is biodegradable. It allows the cells to secrete their own matrix, their natural matrix that they like to grow on, and the scaffold keeps degrading and disappearing over time, so the cells would integrate on top of their own matrix in the back of the eye with the surrounding tissue. So one of the main hopes for us is for this phase one trial is to demonstrate that one can do clinical trials with patients on iPS cells, and then we can demonstrate that patients on RPE patch can be delivered safely to the back of the eye, can stay and integrate safely to the back of the eye, and hopefully start functioning over time. Patients are really the champions of this trial because, as you know, this is a phase one safety trial, and patients have to commit to this experimental procedure. So all their efforts are for altruistic reason because this may one day affect and one day help save vision of thousands of patients.
Logos for the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and for the National Institutes of Health, National Eye Institute. NEI.NIH.gov.